What's up, guys? I wanted to make a video to talk about something that I feel like so many people are not doing before they build PCs, and that is benching your hardware before you build. Now, you might be saying, Robey, what does benching your hardware mean? It means building your entire PC outside of your case. Now, you might be thinking about that, Robey, what does that actually do? Why would we actually build your PC outside? Well, there's a couple things. First and foremost, almost everything that could go wrong when you're building your system, you can test before this. Basically, being able to test hardware and then fix any issues, much easier to do in this configuration than if it was inside of your PC once you get everything mounted. Guys, I'll tell you, one of the worst feelings in the world is getting an entire PC built and then hitting power and then figuring out what was actually wrong, come to find out you gotta take the entire thing apart. And this can save you so much time. If you're gonna do this, find a nice open area, preferably someplace like we have plastic here on the floor, someplace where you're not gonna cause a lot of static, and just be really smart about where you set this up. A kitchen counter, kitchen table, there's nothing that's going to either spill on it or you're not gonna cause a short, which is harder than you think, but don't do it on shag carpet. Come on, just be smart about it, right? So you might be saying, okay, if I'm gonna do this, how do I do it, Robey? Like, give me a step-by-step guide on how to do that. And that ends up being actually a little bit of an issue, because doing this hardware and showing you for every potential hardware configuration is actually pretty hard. But, you know, as you can see here, it's actually pretty straightforward. But I did want to go through a couple things as we talk about components, just some things to be aware of as you're doing this that will help you along the way. Let's start with the motherboard. So first and foremost, with your motherboard, what you're going to do is I put my RAM specifically in the slots that I'm going to be doing. I will seat that normally. You can see that I'm also sticking it on top of the actual motherboard box itself. And you might be saying, why is that so important? Well, I'll get more to that when we get to the GPU section. In terms of hooking things up, is I'm making sure that my CPU fan header, my cooling and stuff like that is actually on the correct header, and that everything for the AIO and everything like that is actually correct. And then the other thing too is that making sure that my power connections are actually in all of the right places where I plan on doing them in my build. Now, the cool thing about this is by doing this, the one thing that gets really straightforward is when you do builds like your Corsair 5000Ds or whatever it is that you're gonna build in, you can start thinking through, okay, well, where am I gonna plug in my fans? Where am I gonna plug in my RGB, etc.? Because you can start to plan and then make sure that those headers and things work beforehand. Guys, it is really easy to literally just unplug something while you're having it. Look, I can literally unplug it and plug it back in into another header and make sure that the headers work, right? It's really kind of straightforward, and it's a nice open platform to really kind of get familiar with when you do things. The other thing too is that I also install my NVMe drive, so my NVMe drive is actually installed. It's up to you. I always like to put the cover on just to make sure, because if you wanna make sure that maybe you're using a Gen 5 drive and you wanna know that it's thermally gonna be okay. If it's not thermally okay when it's outside of the case, it's not gonna be thermally okay when it is inside of the case. Okay, so that kind of covers the motherboard. Let's talk about the AIO. The other thing that you can do, and I'll show you this here in a minute, is that you can also test your cooling capability. You can basically put the cooler on, get it all hooked up. You can actually install Windows, install BIOS in this configuration and verify that it works and that it thermally is able to manage your PC outside of this. The other thing too is when you do an AIO, all you gotta do is stand it up. You can set it out, you can lay it down. People think that these parts are super fragile. They're not fragile, guys. It's okay, these are made of metal and plastic. I like this position because it has a tendency to be more stable. That's the only reason I have a tendency to do this. But the more important thing is run Cinebench. If it can't thermally work out here in this open air scenario, it's not gonna work in your case, which means now I don't have to rip an AIO out of my chassis. I can basically just replace my AIO, throw that one back on my bench when I'm done, verify it works, and then when I do my build, I know I'm gonna be good to go. Next up, let's talk about GPU. This is the reason right here. If you look over here on this side, you can actually see that I've got my GPU just hanging off and it gets enough support. This is the reason that you wanna basically build this on the box. You know that this is statically gonna be fine. You're not gonna get any electrical charges. But the other thing too is it ends up being a really, really nice support for your GPU. Last thing here is let's talk about power supply. Because this is outside of here, you could do things like run FirmMark and Cinebench at the same time, run PCMark, test some overclocking, all those sort of things, and make sure that your PSU, which is going to be the most integrated thing into the case. You guys are seeing some shots here of some of my cable management. Dude, having to rip this out after cable management, it sucks, right? So by testing all of this before you've cable manage all these wires into your case, you know that you have more than enough power for what you need and that there's not a problem with this PSU and that your GPU and all that stuff is gonna work. The way that you essentially power it off is if it's in the BIOS, you can just save and quit and then you can power that off normally. But I'm gonna show you the trick that's actually really important. So what you're gonna do is whatever screwdriver you're gonna use, all you're gonna do is you're gonna take this and on your motherboard, there are two pins and they're power pins. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna connect those together and that's how you turn it on. And then if you wanna turn it off, you just connect those power pins again and it won't shut off. You'd have to hold it down, but if you keep them shorted, it'll shut them off. So that's, you might be saying when you get done doing all this stuff, Robey, if I don't have a power switch, how do I turn it on? There's two ways to essentially do it. Another way that I've seen, which is kind of interesting, is you take your case and you take your power thing and you plug that in and then you just use the power button with it outside. That's kind of bulky. This way just seems a whole lot easier and all you need is a standard screwdriver. So, I mean, again, you're gonna save yourself a bunch of time basically being able to put all your hardware in, test it, figure out your planning. Now, the other part that's really rad, and now you guys are sitting over the screen, is that from here, I can also do things like update my BIOS. So I can update my BIOS, make sure that my BIOS is up to date, make sure that I don't have anything faulty with the chipset or the motherboard. I've had circumstances where we've used, some of the off-brand or more inexpensive brands of RAM, and I pop them in here, and then I set the expo timing or the XMP timing or the DOCP timing, and it doesn't boot. That way you don't have to worry about that. You can just basically make sure that works and get swap a new set in, all that sort of stuff much, much easier. The other thing too is that for Intel, and this is only a Core Ultra problem, you can also make sure that you have compatible Core Ultra 200S boost. And at the same time, you can do things like mess with the RGB and stuff like that inside if you want to. And then we're gonna go ahead and pop out of this and we'll go into Windows. But the last thing I was gonna kind of tell you is that you can also install Windows. So like I said, this can be a fully functioning PC that's completely outside of your case and your chassis to completely tinker with before you take all of that time to make it look absolutely beautiful inside. So when we come in here, I'm just gonna go up here, run Cinebench here. I got 8 to 64 on here. Basically, I can run games on here and I can make sure that I'm not having any hardware issues whatsoever. So here I am, I'm just gonna running in here. You guys can see that it goes. I've got my, I can set my fan curves. And then the best thing is that from there I can totally check my temps to make sure that my temps are good and all that sort of stuff outside of the case. But here you are, it's sitting there, it's benching. And again, I can go and see what my performance and see that everything is working the way it needs to beforehand. Hopefully this guide was helpful, because what I think this is going to do is by using this guide, essentially you're going to save yourself a ton of time when you build your PC and to be able to build it with more confidence, knowing that everything you're gonna throw in there when you're done, it's not the wheels of fate when you close your eyes and push that button. Odds are it's gonna turn on.